the heart of a combat leader. Have you ever stood strong when fear was all around? I mean, did you actually stand tall while others fell to the ground? Have you ever done what common sense said not to do? Even when others ran and said, come on, man, don't be a fool. Has fear ever gripped you so tightly that you had to concentrate? I mean, concentrate just to breathe. I'm talking about the kind of fear that brings even the strongest men down to their knees. Have you ever had to remain calm and lead others to a safe place while fear was clouding your judgment and causing your heart to race? Have you ever been so engulfed by fear that 48 hours passed without you missing a single beat? Heck, almost went 3 days on 2 hours of sleep. Have you ever thought, I mean actually thought, this could be the last breath I take? Because there was death all around me with no room for error, absolutely no room for a leadership mistake. Have you ever been so frozen by fear that you didn't know what to do? I have, but I had to go on because 237 soldiers were looking at me to lead them through. See, fear in the face of a leader, well, it can destroy the will of many people, while fear that goes unfaced could become deadly and extremely lethal, all right? Well, have you ever had to give an order for someone to do something that even you were afraid to do yourself? I mean a command so crazy you wouldn't do it for all the world's wealth? Have you ever had to send somebody out on a mission that you knew they might not complete? That would be one of those nights where this leader didn't get any sleep. Have you ever had to give CPR to someone who worked for you? Well, I worked on Specialist Sierra for about an hour, but he didn't pull through. Have you ever had to carry the body of someone who saved your life? The whole time I was thinking, what in the world am I going to tell his wife? Have you ever had to tell someone that her loved one was no longer alive? Trust me, you can actually see her heartbreaking through the tears flowing from her eyes. Have you ever stood over the body of someone who was dead due to an order you gave? Look, don't stand too close to the funeral because you might want to jump into his grave. Have you ever had to stand before a grieving family? Yes, it is completely sad. Their soldier gave his life for this country, and all I had to give him back was a U.S. flag. See, I'm a leader of soldiers because that is what I was called to do. And just for the record, I'm not wearing this and telling you all this to prove anything to you, because see, most people don't understand a true combat soldier, warrior, leader. Well, here's some insight for you poetry readers. How did you feel? How did you feel when the World Trade Center fell, the Pentagon got hit, and those planes hijacked? This soldier, this leader was devastated. Thousands dead on my watch. And it was my job to prevent that attack. You really don't understand the sacrifices we made for the armed forces. Heck, I missed birthdays, holidays, anniversaries, and been through a couple of divorces. We learned loyalty, honor, respect for the U.S., for government, and for freedom. But see, we actually fight for our fellow soldiers. You'd understand if you ever took the time to meet them. So yes, yes, I face fear for you, you, and you, and even those that act like complete jerks. Because failure is not an option for me when I go to work. See, I'm the former slave turned into a soldier. So here's my quote. I fought for this country before I even had the right to vote. I'm the Buffalo Soldier who fought the Indians and settled the West. Absent from those history books, it's my blood, sweat, and hard work that helped build the U.S. I bravely charged the San Juan Hill and was later discredited in the press because, see, racism would not let this world view me as the nation's best. I'm that courageous, hardworking sailor who signed up at the local rally to learn that I could only serve my country from deep in the ship's galleys. I'm the black flyer who defied all odds to fly, fight, and win. Well, you might have heard them say I'm one of those red-tailed Tuskegee Airmen. I fought in all the U.S. conflicts, to include 2 world wars, to stop global oppression. But it wasn't until the Korean War that we overcame segregation. The media and the public want you to call me a hero. But you treated my Vietnam brothers, those leaders, like complete zeros. Those Vietnam soldiers followed orders, fought with honor, and had no regrets. But when they came home to your insults. No cheers, just total disrespect. Well, this soldier has faced his fears through multiple wars in the Middle East. But I salute those soldiers dealing with fear right now so we can enjoy poetry here on these Virginia streets.
Right.